figure out where that was coming from, and it was coming from Staff Sergeant, right? Staff Sergeant Melanie Allen. And she's going to bless us this morning by singing a song, and she is classically trained. She went to college and then went to extra schooling after that, even now studying opera. And so coming out of the Army, this kind of voice is just amazing. It kind of reminds me of Jim Neighbors, you know, when he was there, Gomer Pyle. But when he, on that first show that he ever sang before he became famous for singing, you know, he just, oh, and the sergeant was just going crazy. So this may be one of your best kept secrets here. Melanie Allen, full time out here. Her husband's here this morning. What's your first name again?
Tony.
Tony, let's welcome Tony here. Tony gets an introduction because you retired from the Army, Army National Guard. So would you listen prayerfully? And also, I have to be careful on her name because in college, I think she said her roommate was named Melody. But hers is Melanie. So you had Melanie and Melody. Melanie is going to sing a melody. Oh, let's welcome Melanie here.
Thank you.
just need to break out. Take a Bible, if you will, this morning and turn with me to 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 3 through 9. 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 3 through 9. And in reverence for God's beautiful holy word, would you stand as I read these verses aloud? Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again into a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible, undefiled, that fades not away, reserved in heaven for you. Lost my place there. Verse 5. Who are kept by the power of God through faith in the salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. Wherein you greatly rejoice, though now for a season, if need be, you are in heaviness through manifold temptations, that the trial of your faith, being much more precious than that of gold that perishes, though it be tried by fire, might be found unto praise, honor, and glory at the appearing of Christ, whom having not seen you love, whom though now you see not, yet believing, you rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, even the salvation of your soul. Let's bow together for a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, again, we thank you for this morning. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for this beautiful song that's been sung by Melanie. O Divine Redeemer, remember not our transgressions, O God. So thank you, Father, for ministering to us through your music this morning. And I pray now that you'll minister to us through your spoken word. I pray, O Lord Jesus, that you be glorified in this and that your Holy Spirit would stir our hearts, that even in the darkest, direst situations we find ourselves in, that we still find reasons to rejoice. Bless each one, I pray, and we'll thank you for it in Jesus' precious name. Amen. You may be seated. Reasons to rejoice. Today we look at five different reasons from God's Word. But we know that there's a difference in joy and happiness. Happiness is dependent upon your circumstances. Joy is that which comes from the Lord. It's that inward sense of satisfaction and security, of stability, that you know everything's going to be all right regardless of what happens. What you've got to understand is Peter here was writing, some believe it was Jewish Christians, those Jewish believers who had embraced Jesus as the Messiah.